Hey everyone, Jeremy here from FruitTube Productions, and today we got the basic 2, part 2 of the basics for Apple scripting using the script editor, the basic programming script for Apple that's script editors are already default built in on all Macs I'm aware of. There should be a project files download in the description, so check it out. Download that, then hit play again. Let's go ahead and open script editor, move it over. I'm just going to recap last time what we did. We did the beep, then we added a number at the end, then we also did the say command and just words.
Hello.
Alright, press command A, delete, type in. Well, I guess it should. What we're gonna do is we're gonna be building, on today's episode, we're gonna be building a dialog box, a one-line text box, and learn how to change the buttons from the default to custom. So let's go ahead, type in, display dialog, quotation, hello, world, quotation, compile, run. There, you have your little dialog box that pops up, and then you got your default buttons, cast on OK. Well, if you wanted to change those buttons, type in buttons at the end, squiggly bracket, I'm not sure what the word is, sorry. Quotation, button 1, quotation, you can name whatever you want, and then end squiggly line, compile, run, there. You can only have 3 buttons, so if you would like to put 3 buttons, just widen this a little bit. After the quotation, type in a comma, quotation, button 2, quotation, comma, quotation, button, button 3, quotation, compile, run. There you go. Sorry if MSN talks to me, I'll be quick. There, learn how to talk, change the buttons and display a dialog. Press command A, delete it all. Now we're going to do the one line text box. Just type in display dialog again. Quotation, username. Now here we type in default answer. And then we type in 2 quotations. If you would like there to be like a text inside of the one line text box, you would just type hello inside those 2 quotations and then there we are. Oh, make sure to spell default right. Run, and as you can see it's inside, so you have to have those quotations after default answer no matter what, but you just leave there no word in the 2 quotations, you got nothing. And then type in buttons and squiggly bracket quotation sign in. This is just kind of not really like real. Compile. Oh, what am I doing? Oh. Gotta spell those words right. Run. There you go. On the next episode, I'm just going to be showing you how to use the say command and kind of use it with the default answer command. Keep it real, YouTube.